So have you lost your data because your hard disk died, or your pile of external drives leaves you less than satisfied? No stress! Today at Your Mother No Teach, I'm going to teach you all about the NAS that will impress, no matter if you're running a production house or any other form of small-medium enterprises. Here's a storage solution with no compromises and no nasty surprises. So what the nasty goreng is a NAS? Can makan ah? Of course not, bro. A NAS is a network attached storage, which is basically a standalone storage device that acts as a central location for you to store and retrieve your data and files. So as long as you have a device connected to the same network as your NAS, you'll be able to access the data on it. Also, some NAS can even be run as a private cloud, which means that you can connect to it no matter where you are on this planet, as long as you have a viable internet connection. Now that you know what a NAS is, why do small medium enterprises even need one? Well, if you run any sort of business, you're gonna be needing a data management and storage device. No matter if it's your customers' data, project files, or your very secretive prawn collection, documents, right? If you don't store them properly with the proper protection, when you lose it without any backup, you are pretty much screwed. And 9 months later, you'll be giving birth to a whole new set of problems that will never go away and will probably haunt you for life. That's why, listen to me. And the moral of the story is, when it comes to data and dating, please use protection. Here are the four main reasons why you should be getting a NAS for your SME. Number one. Bang for your buck. Now, a decent NAS with a good configuration of NAS drives is not exactly cheap. But then you're running a business, not charity, so you have cost of business. It is still cheaper than a traditional rack mount server, so come your memories. Take this Qnap TS453BT34 Bay NAS for instance. Not only does it have the Intel Celeron J3455 quad core processor that can run up to 2.3 GHz in boost, it also has two Thunderbolt 3 ports, one 10 gigabit Ethernet port, and two SATA M.2 SSD slots. We have decked this NAS out with four Iron Wolf 8TB drives for a total of 32TB of storage depending on your RAID configuration, which I will talk to you about later in the video. Don't judge a NAS by its cover. It may look like a toaster, but it runs like a dream and serves like a server. Not only is there an app center that has a lot of apps that will help you with your business, it also can run as a private cloud, which is so important right now because of the global pandemic, and you should be staying home and working from home and playing with your wife. No, play with your kids. Don't play with your wife, she has feelings. This Qnap NAS is actually compatible with the Iron Wolf Health Management as long as you upgrade the OS to QTS 4.3.5 and above. Number 2. Ease of use and expandability. When you buy a NAS, it needs to have a user-friendly interface because you are an SME. You cannot afford a full-blown IT staff to help you handle these kind of things. Also, it needs to be expandable according to your needs as you grow your business, which means you need to be able to constantly upgrade your storage if it runs out of space without going through a lot of hassle. Now, this is why I recommend that you get a 4-bay NAS and not a 2-bay if you're running a business. 2-bay NAS should be reserved for people who want to run an extensive prawn collection at home. You use this. Listen to me, I'm never wrong. Number 3. Security. Now if you love a woman, you also need to put a ring on it. And if you're taking a number 2, you also need to put a lock on it. Your files are as vulnerable as anything else important in your life. So you need some sort of protection when it comes to your data. Also, if you're a boss like me, you need a bird's eye view of your entire operation. But your employees don't need access to everything, so you need to let them have different access. So use like a NAS, set like user control, then you are set. Some more, now it's 2020, a lot of people sudah kena hack lah, celebrity lah, politicians lah. You don't want to be one of those people that kena hack and then cry about it later. Don't say I didn't warn you, huh? Number 4, redundancy, which is basically a very fancy name of saying backup. Correct not, intern?
Yeah lah, like that's need to ask.
Kilo, alam, ebo, tua, bo, say, huh? Anyways, of course you need backup. If your files are not backed up and you actually get a corrupted drive or some sort of mechanical damage to your drive, everything will be kaput. And if you ever tried to pay for data recovery before, you know it is very, very expensive. Have some backup, okay? Especially in a NAS like this with 4 bays, you have a couple of different redundancy-oriented RAID configurations that you can run. You can run a RAID 10, which will give you the benefits of the speed as well as mirroring with your data, but you will only be left with half the capacity of your all your drives. Or you can run a RAID 5 if you're more kiasu like me. So you will just lose the capacity of one drive inside. So with 32 terabytes, you actually get 24. So basically, if you run an SME, I recommend that you run at least a 4-bay NAS. You could run a lower spec one than this one because this is pre-decked out, but try to run a 4-bay. At least you have a bit more expansion possibility as you grow your business. You don't have to buy a new NAS all over again. Maybe you just need to upgrade your drives. Maybe you were running an 8 TB drives in all bays. Now you can upgrade to 12 TBs and so on and so forth. Also, don't cheap out on your storage. NAS drives like this is actually designed to run for NAS operations, which means that they'll be turned on almost 24/7 every day while you access your data from anywhere around the world, okay? If you cheap out and use a normal hard drive, you're gonna have a lot of problems because they'll break a lot sooner. They're not designed to be used like that. So that's all for our Your Mother No Teach today, NAS edition. I hope you learned something. Thank you Qnap for sending this over for us to teach you guys about what a NAS can do for you in your SME, as well as Seagate for sponsoring hard drives for us, because we run a content production house and we make a lot of 4K content, which means all our drives are full almost all the time and we needed a solution for that. So stay home, stay safe, work from home, keep your data safe and don't come out and run here, run there. And I'll see you in the next Your Mother No Teach, brought to you by MOBHouse Productions.